Okay, let me start the lesson today. Today I will talk about how can we program in tree. But first of all, I have to review you a bit about the tree definition and the tree data structures that you have already studied in the course discrete mathematics, right, in the previous semester, right? So this is what we call tree, right, in real, right? But in terms of the tree in computer science, right, you might have to think about the tree like the upside down tree, right? Because we want to start from the root, but the root is on the top level, okay, on the top like this, right? And so if you compare this one, this figure with this figure, right, root will be on the top, right? And then you can go to the lower level of tree, right? So we can call it branch or whatever, but for the node that is on the terminal, right, at the terminal, or sometimes in the real world we can call it leaf node, right? So this can call leaf node as well, right? When you know that the node there is no further nodes from the current node. For this example, if we have a node 3, we don't have any node below 3, right? So we can say that this one is a leaf node, right? Maybe we have already studied this one before, and today I will remind you again about the tree concept. And this is the list of the outline that we will talk today. Okay, this is about the tree, right? First of all, I would like to introduce you the basic terminology for trees, right? I've just told you that we have to start the tree from the root node, right? From the root node, right? If you can see this figure, you can see that A is a root node. What does it mean by the root node? Root node R is the topmost node in the tree. And if R is set to null, okay, it means that the tree is empty. So first of all, for the initialization of the tree, right, if you could remember initialization of the tree, right, you may have to set R, right, R will be the root of the tree, okay? And then R is set to null, right? What does it mean by this? It means that the tree is empty. That means that we are trying to initialize the tree. And the next one is subtree, right? If you have a tree, you also have the subtree of a tree, right? If the root node R is not null, right? Then the tree T1 or T2 or TT can be called it as the subtree of R. From this example, we can have three branches, right? T1, T2, and T3, right? And T1 subtree will be like this, B, E, and F, and T2 subtree will be like this, right? C, G, J, K, right? And the last one, T3, right? We have subtree like this. So this we call subtree. And what about leaf node? Right, we have just talked about the leaf node before, right? A node that has no children is called the leaf node or the terminal node. Sometimes we can call it terminal node, right? From this figure, right, what are the list of leaf nodes? Can you tell me? Can you tell me what are the leaf nodes? If you cannot answer, you can type, thank you very much, Siriwagun. E-F-J-K-H-I, right? E-F-J-K-H-I. They are the nodes that has no children, okay? And the last one in this slide, path. What does a path mean? What does a path mean? It means a sequence of consecutive edges. Consecutive edges is called a path, right? In this example, the path from the root node A to I can be given as A, D, and I. A, D, and I, right? This is a path, right? If this is one path in this tree, right? That's connecting from the root node A to the node or the leaf node I. This is, we call this a path, right? We may use this one, the path in the graph representation, right? Okay, this is the path. Okay, and next we have the ancestor node and descendant node as its name, right? When we talk about an ascender of a node is any predecessor node of the path from root to that node, right? So we sometimes we can call parents node, all parents node, all parent nodes, right? That we call ancestor node. If I ask you what is or what are the ancestor nodes of E, ancestor node of E will be B and A, only A and B, right? Will be ancestor node. And what is the ancestor node of K? It will be G, C, and A, right? So we can say that root node is an ancestor node of every node in this tree. Okay, this is the meaning of the ancestor node. How about the descendant node? Descendant node will be in opposite, right? It's any successor node of or any part from the node to the leaf node. For this example, if I ask you to show me the descendant node of G, the descendant node of G will be the child node or the children node, child nodes of G, that is J and K, right? There are two descendant nodes for G node. Okay, in this figure, node C, G, J, C, G, J will be the descendant node of A. Okay, A is a ancestor of C, G, J, K. Okay. And the next terminology that you might have to know, that is a level number. What does it mean by level number? Every node in the industry is assigned a level number in such a way that the root node is at level zero. Simply speaking, right, when we talk about the leaf node, level of the root node is zero. And then this will be one, level one, level two, and level three, and so on. Okay? You might have to remember that for the root node, right? The root node is the node of level, or the root node is at level one. Right, level one. Okay? This is simple. So I will move to the next one. The next terminology that you might have to know, that is a degree of the tree, right? Degree of a node is equal to the number of children that a node has. The degree is the number of children that the node has. For this example, you can see that the degree of a leaf node is zero because they have no children, right? E has the degree zero. What is the degree for degree of node? Is the number of children that a node has. How many children that A has? Three, right? How many children that node G has? Two. So we also have in degree and out degree. In degree of a node is the number of edges arriving at that node. And out degree is a node, is the number of the edge leaving that node. Arriving that node means C to G, right? Arriving. So this is in degree of G, right? And out degree of G is the number of degree is two, right? The number of the edge leaving the node. Okay, this is the basic terminology of the trees. And okay, that's not important. But the most important thing that you might have to know that is the type of the trees, and you have to understand the definition. You have to know or give me that some examples of the tree, the given tree, right? For example, if I ask you to show me the binary trees, right, you may have to draw a binary tree, right, according to its definition correctly. Okay, this is a thing that you may have to know, that you have to understand. You have to know how to use, or sometimes you may have to know why do we have to use this kind of tree. In general, we have 6 types of tree, right? Starting from general tree, forest, binary tree, binary search tree, expression trees, and tournament trees, right? I'm not going to talk about all of these things. Maybe I just I will show you just only some important tree. Okay, starting from the general one, that is a general tree, right? When we talk about tree in general, a tree is a data structure that we use to store elements hierarchically. Right, we have to store, we can use a data structure tree, right, oftenly, right? So in this way, we will have the top node of the tree that we can call it as the root node, right? And each node except root has a parent, right? Okay, root node is a parent of every node in the tree, okay? And a node in a general tree except the leaf node may have 0 or more subtrees. Okay, that's right. Okay, except the leaf node, right? A node, when you are considering a node, right? They will have, if we have 0 or more subtree. Okay, this is the definition. And general trees which have 3 subtrees per node, we can call ternary trees. Okay, we have already seen the example of the ternary tree. Ternary means tree, right? This example, right, A is a ternary tree because they have 3 subnode, A has 3 subtree. Right. However, the number of subtree for any node may be variable. Okay, we don't have to fix the number of the subtree of each node, right? This is a general tree, right? The tree in general. For example, a node can have 1 subtree. That's possible. Or sometimes we can have 3 subtrees, right? We can call it ternary tree. And if you have the node or the tree that has only 2 subtree for each level of tree, we can call it binary tree, right? Binary tree. Binary means 2, right? So you can have at most 2 subtree for each node. 2 subtree for each node. That, and this one is going to be the thing that we will talk later, that is a binary tree. But before we go to the concept of the binary tree, we will talk about, we have to remind you about the forest. Forest as its name, right? Because forest, there are many, many trees, right? And forest can be a disjoint union of trees. We can also have B, which is a tree, tree, and trees, right? We have three trees here, and then we can combine them into a forest, right? So a forest, a set of disjoint trees, or forest can be obtained by deleting the root and the edge. It's just connecting the root node to nodes at level 1, right? For this example, what does it mean? Right? Suppose we have a tree, right? But if you want to change from a tree to forest, you can just simply delete this node. Node A, right? And this part will be eliminated, and then you can have forest, right? The disjoint tree, right? There's a set of disjoint tree that we can call a forest, okay? And the next definition is a tree can also be defined as an ordered set of 0 or more general trees, ordered set of general trees. While a general tree must have a root and a surface or a forest, on the other hand, may be empty because by definition of set and set can be empty. So if we have all the empty set of tree, this empty set can also be called forest as well, right? Because of the definition, right? Because a set can be the number of the element in this set can be zero, and empty set can be a forest as well. So this is just the mathematical definition of the tree and the forest. Okay, so this one can be the spatial case of the forest. Up to now, do you have any questions to ask me about the terminology and about the previous concept of the tree? If you don't have any question now, I will move to the most important tree that we can call, and we also used it frequently. That is a binary tree. As its name, right, a binary tree is a data structure that is defined as a collection of nodes, and we have only two subtrees for each node, right? In a binary tree, the topmost element can be called a root node. That is general. And each node, we have 0 or 1 or 2 children. The most is 2 children, right? The number of the descendant or the subtree, right? A node that has a 0 children, we can call it as a leaf node. Leaf node, that is a node that has 0 children, okay? And binary tree, you can have 0, 1, or 2 children, right? A leaf node, right? You can call it terminal node. Every node contains a data element, a left pointer, which points to the left child, and a right pointer, which points to the right child. This is the basic concept of the binary tree, and we can write it in terms of the C program like this. Oops, where is it? Okay, this is the representation of the binary tree, right? Suppose you want to define a binary tree, right? You have, first of all, you have to define the structure node. Structure node, right? And the structure node will contain the data like this, right? So you can have one or more data, it's up to you, right? Because you have already implement many nodes, for example, stack, queue, right? By using array or using the linked list, right? And data can be one or more, right? This is the important data that you have to keep inside the binary tree. But the most important element in binary tree will be left and right node, right? So we have to define data structure node, right? Structure node, and you have to define it in terms of the address, right? You can use asterisk or star in order to refer to the address in memory, right? And address will point to the left and the right, and this one will be represented as the left subtree and right subtree of this tree. Okay, because we have at most two subtrees or two child nodes for each node, right? So you can have to implement it in terms of left and right. That will represent the link to the left and the right subtree. Okay, this is a C program for binary tree. And then come back to the definition of the binary tree, right? Okay, first of all, we have to start from the definition of the binary tree, and then, right, we have the root element is point to the root pointer, right? And root pointer, we have two left. This one is left, and this is the right pointer, right? If root is equal to now, so it means that this tree is, this binary tree is empty. In this figure, right, shows a binary tree, right? And there are two subtree, that is T1 and T2, right? We have only two subtree, right? And we can call them left and right subtrees respectively. And T1 is said to be the left ancestor of R, and T2 is also called the right ancestor of R. So it can be noticed that the left subtree of the root node consists of the node, 2, 4, 5, 8, and 9. And the right subtree will consist of 3, 6, 7, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, this is an example of binary tree. Okay, so similarly to the terminology that I have already talked about in the previous slides, right? What does it mean? What is the parent of the root of the binary tree, right? The root node. This one is a parent of every subtree, every node in this tree. Okay, and the level number will start from 0, 1, 2, and 3, because binary tree is quite specific. So if you are trying to map the terminology to the binary tree, right, you will get the specific definition of the binary tree. For this example, if you want to make it an ordered binary tree, right, starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So you can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on, right? In order to do this, right, we may have to list the number in the ascending order of the numbers, right? Starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? And when you press the label of the number into the binary tree, you can fix and you can know exactly where that particular node will be according to the number, right? Okay. What does it mean by this is if I say that in level 0, what is the root number? The root number or the node number will be 1, right? 1, right? Because you know that it is on the in the level 0. Okay, the next example, if you want to know the label of the node in the level 1, right? It will be 2 and 3. Right, 2 and 3. So you can guess or you can define or determine the number of the labels for each node in each level, right? Level 1, level 0. Level 0, the maximum node will be 2^0. Okay. That is 1. And how about 2^1? Okay, no, I have to say like this. It will be 2^+1 and -1. So you can get 2 - 1 = 1. This is the maximum number of this level. And how about the second level? 2, 1+1, -1 will be 4, -1, that is 3. 3 will be the maximum number of this level or level 2. Okay, how about the level 3, right? It's supposed to be 7, right? You can have 2^2+1. That is 8, -1 will be 7. So you can get the maximum number here as well as this. Okay, this is the maximum number that you can guess or you can calculate it from the level number, right? Because the binary tree is a specific tree, right? So you will know the exact definition of the binary tree, right? Okay, we also have this one, level 0, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and then we also have the definition of the degree of a node, right? It is equal to the number of the children that the node has, right? The degree of the leaf node is 0, right? This is degree of the leaf node will be 0. And the maximum degree of each node in binary tree will be 2. That's right, because of the definition of the binary tree, the maximum number or the maximum degree of binary of the node in binary tree is 2. How about siblings? Siblings, all nodes that are the same at the same level and share the same parents, they will call siblings or brothers. For this example, what are the siblings of the node 2? Siblings, not true. Can you answer me? Please type in your chat box. So I can ask you for the class attendance as well. What is a sibling? Sibling of the node 2. Can you type? Can you type into chat box? Oh, good. 27, 28, 30 students. Okay, thank you really much. I think I have known the answer, right? The sibling of the node 2 is 3. That's correct. Okay, that's correct. Okay, you can see from the examples, right? When we ask for the sibling of the node 2, it will be 3. The sibling of the node 4 will be 5. The node 6 and 7, they are siblings. And 8, 9, and 10, 11, right? If you can see that from these patterns, you can see that the sibling node will be close to each other, right? The sibling node will be close to each other. Right, when you have the ask for the sibling of 2, its sibling will be 2 + 1, that is 3. And if I ask you to find the sibling of 9, which is odd number, right? You have 2 - 1, and the sibling of 9 will be 8. Right? This is the equation, right? If I ask for the sibling of the node that is even, it will be the node n, and n is even. So sibling of n will be n + 1. But if I ask the sibling of the node n, but n is odd, So the sibling number will be n minus 1. Okay, this test is good already. Okay. Leaf node. But when we talk about the leaf node, right? A node that has no children, right? If I said that there, can you explain again? Again, what about a sibling, right? Okay, you can see from this one. Okay, if the sibling of 2, right, 2 is even number, right? So the sibling of 2 will be 2 plus 1, that is 3. Am I right? But if the question or the exam will show you to ask the sibling label of node 9, 9 is odd, right? So it will be n minus 1, which is 8. 8 will be the sibling of 9. Okay, do you get the point? Thank you very much for your question. Mm-hmm. Okay. The next question. If I have a binary tree with the highest level is 3, what will be the leaf node of the tree? If the maximum number of the level is 3, what are the list of the label of the tree, of the leaf node? Okay, it will be 8, 9. Okay, this one is very special, right? And we are not going to talk about the complete binary tree. Okay, for this example, what are the leaf nodes? 8, 9, 5, 10, 11, and 12, right? We have 6 leaf nodes. What does it mean by leaf node? Leaf node is a node that has no children. Okay, so in this figure, right, we have only 6 leaf nodes. And what we are trying to explain you a bit more about the binary tree, that will be the complete binary tree. Complete binary tree is coming. Okay, before we go to that, right, we have to recap you about the similar binary trees. Two binary trees, T and T prime, are said to be similar if both these trees have the same structure, similar trees, same structure, but it can be different element or different data inside. Copies. Two binary trees are said to be copies if they have similar structure, or we can say that they are similar binary trees if they have the same contents inside. Okay, it's the same content inside. Edge. It is the line connecting a node N to any of its successor. Like a binary tree of n node have only n minus 1 edges. Is it correct? 1 2 3 4 5 we have n is equal to 5 how many h 1 2 3 4 okay 5 minus 1 is equal to 4 h we have all 4 h 4 5 nodes okay this is tautology right if you have 5 nodes that you have n minus 1 edges n minus 1 exactly n minus 1 edges okay this is the clue how about a path a path is a sequence of consecutive edges for example in figure 9.5 9.4 right the path from the root node to the node 8 is 1 2 8 is 1 2 3 right we have 2 4 8 2 1 2 4 8. Okay, this is a path from the node root node, which is 1, and then to the node 8. Right. Okay, how about the next one, the depth of a node n is given as the length of the path from the root to the node n, the depth of the root is 0, that's right. Uh-huh. What is the depth of node j? What is the depth? 0, 1, 2, 3. 3 is the depth of J. The height of a tree. If the total number of nodes on the path from the root node to the deepest node in the tree, right? The height of the tree. Is that the depth? But if you want to ask for the height of the tree, you have to count from the root. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 will be the height of a tree. The height of a tree is the height. It's the total number of nodes on the path from the root node to the deepest node in the tree. Okay? A tree with only a root node, you have the height of 1. It is raining at my house. Someone said that it is the first day of summer or the summer has been begun. But it is a raining day today. I don't know why. Okay, so here we go. We will go to the next one, the next concept, that is a complete binary tree. A complete binary tree is a binary tree that satisfies two properties. The first one is it is complete. It is every level except possibly the last is completely filled. So what does it mean? If you are in the first level or level 0, the root node must be presented. And then for the level one, right, this is 2 and 3 must be filled. On level 2, this one, 4 nodes will have to be exist, right? But except for the last, level, right? It's not necessary to be filled all the link, but okay, the last one, we left only 14 and 15, right? But it's not necessary, right? Only the last line or the last level can be missing, okay? But every level, right? All nodes appear as far left as possible, right? Complete every level is completely filled. Okay, this level completely filled, this level completely filled. But level 3, right? Level 3, not necessarily, possibly the last level can be, some can be missed. Some can be missed. Okay. This is a complete binary tree. Okay, I have already talked about the equation of how to calculate the number of the nodes in each level. For this example, you can have the level 0. There are only one node, or 2 raised to the power 0. Right, 2 raised to the power 0 is the number of the node in this level. That is one. 2 raised to the power 1 is equal to 2. That is a number of the nodes in the level 1. 2 raised to the power 2 is equal to 4. 4 is a number of the node in the level 2. Level 3, 2 raised to the power 3, the number of the node should be, the maximum node is 8. But in this example, right, only 6 has been shown, but it's still a complete binary tree, right? Because it is the last level, so it's not necessary to be filled up all, okay? But we can guess, or we can calculate it for the maximum number of the nodes in this level, which is 8, right? So we can compute the number of the nodes in each level by its level. You should have known that the level is 3, so the number of the nodes will be 8. The maximum number of the nodes in level 3 is 8, okay? That is the formula for the 2 raised to the power level. 2 raised to the power level, right? This is the number of elements. You may have to say the maximum number of elements in level, okay. Okay, this is the definition of the complete binary trees and also the some example that's important and some terminologies according to the binary trees, complete binary trees. And that's all for the, not yet, oh, okay. We sort of have one slide left for the complete binary tree. So from this example, you can see that this figure 9.7, this is an example of the complete binary tree, which has exactly 13 nodes. We have only 13 nodes here. Okay, if we want to ask for the height of the node, of the tree, this tree, how can we have the formula for finding the height of, if you know the number of nodes, what is the height of this complete binary tree. Can you give me the equation? And why? Do you understand my question? My question is, can you give me the formula to find the height of the complete binary tree if I know the number of nodes? The answer is the height can be log n plus 1, log n plus 1 base 2 and absolute. Why is that? How can we derive this formula? When n is the number of the nodes. In order to get this formula, right, so we have to start from the height, right? This is height 1, 2, 3, and 4. According to this binary tree, complete binary tree, the height is 4. So what will be the maximum number of the nodes here? 2^4, right? 2^4 is 16 nodes, right? And the maximum nodes in this complete binary tree of the layer of the height tree will be 14 and 15. So the number of the nodes will be 2^4 minus one, right? Right? Why? Where 4 is the height? This one is the number of nodes, right? Now, exactly this one is 15, right? So in order to get 15, right, you might have to plus one, right? In order to get 16 and then take log base 2, so you can get 4, and 4 is the height of this complete binary tree. Okay, what if the node is 13? 13 plus 1 is 14. 14 log 14 base 2 is 3 plus t dot xx, right? So this is supposed to be the ceiling one, right? You have to get this. This should be 4, right? This is the number of the height of this complete binary tree. So from this equation, you might have to use the function ceiling, right? Function ceiling, this one is function ceiling, right? That is to map 3.xx to 4, right? Do you know the function ceiling? So this one you have to change it to ceiling. This one is ceiling function. What does it mean by ceiling function? Ceiling of 2 or 3.89 will be 4. Ceiling of 4 will be 4. Ceiling of 4.1 will be 5. This is a ceiling function. Okay, for this one, the complete binary tree, if you have known the exact number of the nodes, right, you can find, you can compute to find the height of the binary tree or the complete binary tree by using logarithmic function here and function. Okay, maybe not to make it clear, right, here, so you can write it as the ceiling function. I think it should be 20. Oh, from this one, right? This example, 10 mega nodes, right? Should be. What does it mean by? Okay, let me use calculator. Calculator. This is 10 meg. The comma is wrong. Right, the comma is wrong. It should be 1 million, right? 1 million. No, 6. Is supposed to be 1 million. Right? It is. Because my calculator, I cannot find log base 2, right? So I have to find log. One thousand divided by log 2 base 10. Okay, and then you use ceiling. And upper one is 6, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can get 6. And how about log 10 base 2 is 0.3. Okay, and this one is equal to 19.9, and then so this is supposed to be 20. I think the number is too small. Too small. Which one is too small? You can use the calculator. Maybe you can approximate by using ln, one million ln. Cannot. Ln is just 13.8. Yes, but maybe the calculation can be deviated. Why not plus 1 million with one? Oh, that's right. Thank you. Okay, maybe I miss it. I lost it. I have to use 1 million plus one. Thank you, Sri Wahakun. Yes. But in this case, I think it doesn't matter, right? Because 1 million. 1 million and one. Take log base 10, you can get 6.00006 time, and then 4.442. That is very like a hair, very small. And when you divide it, you divide it by 3.3219. So you can get 19.9. So the result should be 20. Okay. I think you have fun enough for this one to calculate and think about the equation to compute for the height of the trees with n node. Okay. And then what will be the next topic that we are going to talk? Okay, this slide we have already passed. There is a representation of the binary tree. Okay, if you want to write programming not to represent a binary tree, you can use the structure node with left and right address. Okay, and then if you want to figure out about, you want to show you the figures of the binary tree, right? I can write it in terms of three elements in this node, right? So in each node, right, we can have the left subtree and right subtree and right link. Okay, in this case, we can have left and right. Right, left will represent to the left subtree of this node, and right will represent the right subtree of this node. Okay, so this is the way of we use the linked list or linked representation of a binary tree. And X will stand for the now pointer. And then you can see that for the leaf node, right? Both left and right links, they are now. They are set to be now, right? If you want to check for the, which one is the leaf node, right? Leaf node, you have the left is equal to now, and then right will equal to now as well, right? Okay, this is the leaf node. Okay. This is a linked representation of the binary tree T. We have the binary tree T here, right? What is the root node? Where is the root? This is root, right? With the data one, and left will point to the 5, and right will point to 8. Okay, let's traverse along the left subtree, right? 5, and then go to 5, and then you have 2, and then go to left again, 9. So we have 3 or 4, and then 1. And 1 you go to here, and then you can have 8. 1, 2, 1, 2, 4, 8, right? Will be the left of the left of the left of the root. Left of the left of the left of the root. Okay. Which is a kind of the tree traversal, right? That we have already studied in the course of this discrete mathematics already. Okay, and we can also represent it in terms of the array like this, or you can use the linked list representation. This is another example of the binary tree, right? In order to store the names of the family members, right? Okay, the family members mean Amma have the successor Janak and Raj and Raj and Palev, and Palev is only one child of Janak. What of this name? Rudask. Rudask. Anyone knows what the name? What is the nationality of this name? Maybe Indian, right? Indians. Deepak. Lishiman. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, this is the link representation for the this tree data structure. Okay. Start from Amma, right? This is a root. Consists of the data is Amma. And 9, the left subtree will be 9, go to Janak, and then Janak go to 1, which is Palev, and then to the left of Shalev, that is 12, elements, this is Ludash. Okay, interesting. Okay. Let me move to another representation of the binary tree, right? We can also use the sequential data structure or the sequential representation of binary trees, right? This can be done using single or one-dimensional arrays. Although it is the simplest technique for memory representation, but it is inefficient as it requires a lot of memory space, right? And a sequential binary tree follows the following rules. The first one is it is a one-dimensional array, right? One-dimensional array like this. And then the root of the tree will be stored in the first location. This is the root, right? We store in the first location, that is 20. And then, as I told you, right, I have taught you about the label, right, of the binary tree, right? You can calculate for the label of the binary tree, and you can use this in order to represent the binary tree in terms of the sequential representation or array, one-dimensional array. The root will start from the first location, and then the two children of this root will be on the 2 and 3. That is a consecutive node or consecutive elements in array, right? So which is 15 and 35, okay? The label number 2 and 3 will be 2 and 3 will be the index of the left and right child left and right children shall not of the root node, that is one. And this is a 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is missing, and this 10, 11, 12, and 13. No, this one is also 12 and 13. This one is 14 and 15. Okay, so in order to keep the binarity of the height 4, right, you need to have 2 raised to the power 4 elements in the array. Okay, the children of a node store in level or the location K, they will store in the location 2 multiplied by K and 2 multiplied by K plus 1. For example, the node 1, right? It is the root node. Where are the child nodes of this node? It will be 2 multiplied by 1, which is 2. And 2 multiplied by 1 plus 1, which is 3. So 2 and 3 will be the child or children of the root node 1. Okay, this is that's why we have this one. That's why we can derive this 2 multiplied by k and 2 multiplied by k plus 1. The maximum size of the array will be 2 raised to the power n minus 1. This is the number of elements for the complete binary tree or the binary tree of the height n. N is the height of the tree. An empty tree and subtree is specified by using now. Okay, that you have already known about this. And then tree index 1 is now, then the tree is empty. Okay, index 0, index 1, right? In this case, if it is null, so it is empty. Okay, so if you want to represent the trees, right, or binary trees, right, there are 2 kinds of the representations. The first one is that you can implement it in terms of the linked list and using left and right links for the left and right subtrees. And the second one is this one is very simple, right? And it is the simplest way to represent binary tree. Even you will have the extra or you have to allocate a lot of memory space, but I think this way is very easy to implement. But if you look back to the linked list, right, if you use linked list, right, in order to represent the binary tree, right, it's very easy to do that because we know the left and the right subtree of each. But for the sequential representation, you may have to calculate all the time about the index of what will be on the left, what will be on the right of the subtree. That you need spatial computation for the sequential representation. But it's up to you, right? If you are good in linked list, you can also use linked list. Even you have the extra memory spared to store for the left and the right links. But if you use binary tree, you can make the use of the memory allocation efficiently. So it's up to you, but you need the more computational time in order to find the right index for this tree or this for each element. The next thing, that is a binary search trees, but we are not going to talk about this into detail because this one will be the topic that we will talk next week, right? Specifically, right? Binary search tree is very important, right? You can know it as an ordered binary tree. Okay, we'll use it in many applications and we'll talk about this later in the next week. Okay, and then we will go to the expression trees. Okay, this one is another application of the trees, right? I have you are familiar with this already from the lab, right? If you want to calculate the algebraic expression or mathematics expression, for example, if you have a minus b and parenthesis and then plus C minus D and parenthesis. What you have to do is you have to represent it in terms of the binary tree. Instead of change this, last time you have to change this, this is the infix, right? You have to convert it into the prefix or postfix notation, right? And then you can calculate for the result or the evaluation of this arithmetic expression. But now you know about the trees, right? In order to convert into the prefix and suffix, right? You may have to convert into the form of the binary tree, right? For this example, you need to perform A minus B first, so you can use minus as a, okay, it for the operators, right? Plus minus multiply, right? It will be the root node of the two operands, right? Which will, okay, C and D will be the operands of this multiply, okay? And A and B, we have minus is an operator of A and B. So what we have to do first will be A minus B first, and then you perform C multiplied by D. And then once you get the result of these two, so you can plus this, you can perform plus left and right value. This is the evaluation of this expression tree in terms of the trees. Okay, in terms of the tree. Okay, that's why we call this one is an expression tree. Okay, let's go to another example. Okay, if it is given an expression like this, right? Construct the binary tree. Okay, we have to perform A plus B first. You can get A plus B, and then A plus B will be C multiplied by D, right? And then minus, so you can get this subtree. And then this subtree will be like this, right? With percent sign, and then you can perform this one, right? And then you can have F and G, right? F and G. H, L, am I right? No, I don't think so. Okay, I think this one is not correct. This is supposed to be F less to the power T. And then this one is H minus L. Okay, so you can come up with this solution. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, is it clear? Okay, I think you all can convert from the a given arithmetic or algebraic expression into the expression trees. I think it's not that difficult. Mm-hmm. Then I will go to the next one. If I have the expression tree, you can convert into the algebraic expression. Okay, you can try to don't to see this one, right? Maybe you can delete this one. Try to hide this. Okay. If you finish to get the expression for the above binary tree, you can type 9 into the box, into the chat box, so I can know that you have already finished this and you can be, I can go to another slide. Okay, thank you very much. There are 37 students can do this one. This, okay, is it correct? Actually, it's like the same as the previous expression tree. Okay, that's not good. That's not a good example. Okay. But at least you can try. You can try. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Okay, the next topic, that is a tree traversal. But you can have fun with this. And then this is the application of the tree. How to combine the tree with the Huffman tree. Huffman court. Okay, we have left tree traversal and Huffman court. Okay, have you anyone in this room? You don't know about the concept of the tree traversal. I think all of you understand. You have already studied about the tree traversal before, right? In course discrete math, this course or the course math or the course discrete mathematics. Okay, what does it mean by tree traversal? If I ask you to give me the definition of the tree traversal, how can we do? Traversal, traversing a binary tree is the process of visiting each node in the tree, every node in the tree exactly once in a systematic way. Okay, this is a good definition for the tree traversal, but we can say, simplest, okay. If you want to visit every node in the trees, right? You may have to use, you have to pick up one technique from tree, right? What are the techniques of the tree traversal? In order, pre-order, and post order, right? There are three kinds of the tree traversal, right? It's unlike the linear data structure, right? You can traverse the tree, right? By using the left and right subtree, along the left and right subtree, right? And there are three different algorithms, right? That you can use to visit the node, all the nodes in the tree. The first one is pre-order. When we talk about pre or in or post order, right? Pre means we will refer to the root node, right? Anytime when we talk about the order, right, we have to consider the root node as the main consideration. Okay, from this example, if you pre means you have to travel along the route first. So from this example, we have a simple binary tree like this, A, B, and C, right? So pre-order means you have to visit route first and left and right. Route, left, right. This is we call the pre-order traversal. Okay, visit route and then and left and right. Okay, this is the way that we try to traverse along this one systematically. Okay, so in order to do that, it's very simple if you write a program. So I'm going to show you about the algorithm of the pre-order. So in the pre-order, right, we have to do while loop, right? And tree will be the pointer to the tree. The pointer to the tree, right? And if it's not equal to now, or it's not empty, if it's not empty, then you can perform three steps like this. The first one is write the tree data. What does it mean tree data? Tree data means the data tree is points here, right? And the data is A. So A will be printed out first. And then you can do pre-order recursively. So this one is like a recursive algorithm, right? You can call pre-order function, right? This algorithm is a pre-order traversal, or we can call pre-order function, right? You can use pre-order of tree, right? So what you have to do is you have to first print the data and then pre-order the left subtree, and then the right subtree. So this is the way that we perform the pre-order traversal. Okay, pre-order traversal are used to extract a prefix notation from an expression tree, or sometimes we can think about it as a prefix notation. Okay, we have already talked about the prefix notation. So this is mean the operator will be extract first. Okay, and the root will be extract first. Okay, this is a pre-order. I'm not going into detail, but if you want to know exactly about how can we implement this one, we will talk about this in the lab into details. Okay, this is a pre-order traversal. So like the pre-order traversal that we have already studied, right? I will show you only one example, right? So in this concept, right, root, left, right. So we have plus, right, and left, minus, and then A, root, left, right, A and B. Then finish left, right, and then we go to the right, right, it's multiply and C and D, multiply C and D, okay? And this one will be the pre-order traversal. Pre-order traversal, okay? And then, okay, these are some examples of the pre-order traversal you can try by yourself. Okay, I'm not going to detail for this because you have already studied this notion before. And in order, the differences between the pre-order and in order is that the left subtree will be first, in means second, right, in. So you will have to perform left, root, and then right. So left, root, and right. Right, this is the order of the execution. So in the program, right, in the program, you have to perform in order, right, left subtree first, and then right data. Tree data means this one is the data for the root, and then right subtree. So and that's all. This is the concept of the in order, right? You have to perform the root subtree, the root, second, left, root, right. Okay, if you want to traverse in order here, right, you have to go, okay, when you visit A, A is the route, you will not write the route. First, you have to go to the left, and then B, right, and then D, and then G, right? So you can have G, and D, and then H, and then L, and then B, and then E, and then A. Okay, in order to do that, okay, I will go like this, A, B, D, left, D, H, L, B, E, A, and then lines up three, okay? Then, okay, pass this, okay, but there is no left, right? So you can have C, and then root, and then left, I, and go back to F, and then go to K, and then J. Okay, this is a way, this is a in order traversal for this tree. Okay. Let's do the second example. A, B, okay, B and D, and go back A. And then C and E, no left, so you can E. And then F, okay, F not yet because we have left. You also have left, so with H, G, I, and then F. And then this one is left sub three, right? Finished, and then C will be root, and then no right. This is root, and this is right, because no right, and then we can end with C. Okay, this is an in order traversal. In opposite to the pre-order, right, we have post-order. The post-order will means that the root will be displayed the last, and then we call left, right, and root, left, right, and root, right? Because it is the last, so it is the post-order, okay? So here we are, we have the post-order traversal for this, right? I'm not going to make you confused about the pre-order and post order, right? So I'm not going to do. So you can come back home and then you can try to see the how it's going on in this example about the post order traversal, right? And then you can write a program. If you have time, you can write a program or C program in order to perform in order, post order, pre order. Right? So you can see that how is the program going on, okay? And the next one is a level order traversal. I think this might be new to you, right? The order, the level order traversal will be like what we call breadth first traversal search, right? We use this kind is the breadth first search. Breadth first. This is the kind of the search or traversal. This is also a searching algorithm. This one will be used in order to, if you want to travel in, how can I say, if you want to travel from one level to another level. For this example, if you want to travel, visit the node A, B, and C, A, B, C, or A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, L, K, okay? Like this, how can we do, right? For this example, A and then B, C, and then D, E, F, and G, and H, I, right? This is what we call level order traversal. How can we write a program? Okay, so this is also important. Maybe this one is, this algorithm is might be interesting. And also it will be used in AI. Sometimes in AI, right, we have two kinds of search. The first one is this one, breadth first search. For the one who are interested in AI, right, you have to know the searching algorithm, right? In this one, the first one is breadth first search. It's like this, like level order traversal. And the next one is depth first search. Depth first search, right? We'll go to the lower and then try to backtrack. We'll go to the lowest level and then try to backtrack until you get the right result. Okay, I'm not going to detail about this, right? But this one will be maybe the first time of you, right? Because you are the first year student, right? You have no idea about the breakfast search, but you will know about this in the course, the next term, right? In algorithm design. Okay, so here we are. Here we go to the almost the last topic that we are going to do, right? That is a Huffman code, right? If you want to create your encoding algorithm or encoding secret, or sometimes you want to zip file or compress the file, right? You have to use the concept of the Huffman code. But before we will go to the Huffman code, I would like to introduce you the way to construct a binary tree from the traversal result. For this example, right? Suppose we have A and DBE in this way. DBE, right? You can convert or you will extract it into DBE, right? What does it mean by DBE? What is the order? Left, root, right. Left, root, right is in order or post order or pre order. In order traversal, okay, in order traversal. Okay, so you can extend this to this, right? This is the way of the constructing a binary tree from tree traversal. And then if you want to, okay, this is a constructing DBHE, FJ. This is supposed to be FI. So this is FI. And then you can get FI like this, and then CG, FICG, DBHE, DBHE. DBHEIO. What? Okay, forget about this one. I think you know how to construct a binary tree from the traversal, right? This one is strange. Okay, let's go to the last topic that you have to know. That is a Huffman tree, right? Normally, Huffman is the name named by David A. Huffman. He is very famous, right, in order to provide you the algorithm in order to do the lossless data compression. Data compression, you can use this in order to zip file, right? This is a good example of the data compression. But sometimes you need lossless data compression. So you have to use the Huffman code. The concept of Huffman code is very simple, right? We use a variable length code table in order to convert from the character into the code 0 and 1, right? Into that we call encoding, right? Encoding technique, right? But in order to do that, the key basic idea behind the Huffman algorithm is that it encodes the most common character using shorter string. What does it mean by that? If you know that E is a common character, right? You need to encode it into the very short bit, okay? But Z or Z is very rare, right? So you can use the long bit, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, long bit, in order to represent this one. This is a key concept behind the Huffman algorithm. But what can we do, right? Okay, this one is our algorithm, right? But I'm going to show you about the how can you represent the Huffman tree in real. Okay, suppose you have the frequency table like this, right? A is the, okay, you can find A in the in your text 7 times. B 9, C 11, D is 14, E is 18, and so on, right? You can find okay, what we, how can we create a Huffman tree, right? If you want to create a Huffman tree, right? We can, okay, first of all, you have to make it into the priority queue. Priority queue means you have to sort the each element, right? By its frequency, right? Frequency, okay? And then the less number of this is Larry to find. Normally when you are trying, when I teach the algorithm design course, right, I will not use the frequency. Normally I will use the what we call the probability, the possibility. Okay, I will have to add this up and then into 100 and then make it to be a percentage of the occurrence, right? Percentage of the occurrence, and that would be easier, like 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, something like that. And this one will be sum up to one. It would be easier. But this one is you just sort by the frequency of the of each character. Okay. Then this one may be just an example, it's not the in the real world, okay? Okay, and what will we do next? Okay, then you have to add up this one, right? Add, okay, after we sort this one, right, according to the number of the occurrence of each character in your text or in your database, right? So first of all, you have to start from the lowest frequency, right? 7 and 9 plus you can get 16, and then you perform, you put it into the tree like this. This is a subtree. And then 16 is greater than 11, right? So you have to combine. You will not combine this together, right? You have to combine this into 25. No, exactly what you have to do is, this one is not a good example. Actually, if you have this is 16, right? You may have to resort this again. So C and D here will be moved to here, right? Because 11 and 14 is less than 16. So you have to combine this together so you can get 25, and then C and D will be mixed together into one tree. And then you have to resort this one, and 18 and 21 will be moved to here, right? Then E and F will be combined. Oh, but we combine this to 16. Oh, this one will be moved to this and also 21 move to this. Okay, in this way, we try to map this to this one, and then you can get 34, and then E is on the left subtree of this node. And then we have 21. You mix 21 with 25. In this, you can get this one. And then from this, you have GH. You mix GH to here. This is 27 and 29. So you can get 56 like this. And then combine this one with the 34, right? So you have 34 and 31 here, you can get 69. Doop, 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 doop. So 40 is supposed to be here, right? But you will map this 40 with what? And 46, where is 46? 46 is here, right? And this one, when you sort this, that you can have 40 here, and then 40 will be here, and then you add them up here, so you can get this one, 86. So you can see that this one we are always sort, right? So 56 and this one will mix to here, and then you can combine this to the 211. So this is the way that the Huffman tree performs. Okay, maybe you can develop your own algorithm, but it will be mixed up like this, right? This is the construction of the tree, right? Construction of the tree. When you get this, and then you can have the way. Now you can create your own code. We use this tree to encode. Okay, how can we encode this one? So this is a simple one, right? Suppose you have the tree like this, right? Okay, so you need the left hand side is 0 and 0. The right hand side will be 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. So you can now you can encode the A will be 0 0 0 0. E will be 0 1 0 1 0 1. And how about R? R is 1 1 1 1. W 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0. X is 1 0 0 0. And Y is 1 0 0 1. And Z will be 1 0 1 1. Like this. This is how can we encode in using the Huffman tree or Huffman code. Okay, do you get the point? How can we create the, okay, A is a commonly used or commonly occurred in your context. Okay, so it will be very short. A and E will be very short, but it's very rare to find W, X, Y, Z, so it will be longer code, longer code, this is shorter. Okay, this is a Huffman code. Okay, here we are to the last page of today's class. Okay, and here we are almost the time, right, about today's class, right? This is a list of the application of the trees, right? And okay, I will show this. Okay, Tree are used to store simple as well as complex data. It can also can collect or store the simple or complex data. Okay, and tree can be implemented by other type of the data structure like hash table, set or maps. Okay, and if you want to balance, sometimes when you try to put the ordered element, for example, I put 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, like this is an order, descending order, right? When you put into the tree, you can get 10 and 9, and then 8, and then 7, and then 6, right? Right, this is the way that we can keep, right? And there is no element on the left, right-hand side. So this one is the unbalanced tree. If you want to make it balanced, you may have to perform red back tree that we are going to talk about this algorithm later, right? Red back tree is a self-balanced tree. It will be automatically balanced the tree, okay? And the red back tree will be discussed in the next chapter, okay? Other type of the tree will be B tree, right? We use B tree to store tree structure on disk. B-tree are also used for the secondary index of in database. In the database, you may have to use a B-tree in order to represent the databases. And tree are important data structure that used for the compiler construction. Okay, if you want to create your own compiler, you may have to use a tree data structure. Or even you want to design a new database, right? You have to use tree. Or even for the file system directory is a good example of the tree as well, right? We have the, okay, you have the folder like this, and then this is subfolder A, subfolder B, subfolder C, right? This also organized in terms of the tree as well, okay? And the last one is tree are also widely used for the information storage and retrieval in symbol table. Okay, you can use symbol table in the compiler construction. Okay, that's all for the concept of the tree and the application of the tree in the real world application. When we talk about the real world applications, we talk about the application in computer science or computer engineer applications. Okay, that is all about of the tree. And then maybe next week we have to try to implement or write a program using tree data structure. Or if you have time, you can try to implement C data structure by using left and right subtree, and then you can perform or write a program in order to do or to perform the tree traversal, T kind of tree traversal. Okay. If you have time, okay, implement. Oh, sorry. Implement trees, right? Okay, let's call binary tree. And then do the tree traversal. What are the tree traversal? In order tree traversal, pre-order tree traversal, and the last one is post-order tree traversal. Okay, this is homework. Okay, try to implement trees, right? We are going to have a lab on a tree next week. Yes, of course, we are also going to have the lab for the tree next week as well. But, okay. Because you have already know about the concept, right, of the tree, right? But if you are willing to try to implement this, you can try to write a program. And then if we for the next week, right, if you have the lab, right, so it would be very easy for you to implement the tree data structure. Thank you for asking. It depends, right? This homework, if you can do this before you go to the lab, right, for the lab, it would be very easy for you. Mm-hmm. But if not, you may be stuck in the lab. Okay, before you leave for this lecture session, don't forget to press something in order to indicate that you are in this class, okay? And I will use this for the class attendance checking, okay? Thank you very much for class, for your coming today and this class, and you can leave the room if you like. Mm-hmm.